membawakan tentang akustik tomografi. Waktu itu beliau memaparkan itu dan saya langsung tertarik. Kenapa? Karena akustik tomografi terutama yang di pantai ini belum ada. Yang saya tahu di Amerika memang berkembang, pertama kali memang dikembangkan di sana, itu pun belum lama. Jadi itu ocean akustik tomografi. Ya, jadi OAT, bedanya ocean and coastal. Saya tertarik, saya lulus, saya kontak beliau. Seharusnya saya melanjutkan PhD di Universitas Columbia dengan bimbingan Arnold Gordon waktu itu. Terus saya kontak beliau, saya tertarik dengan akustik, bisa enggak saya belajar akustik di sana ngambil PhD? Padahal saya on the way pindah ke Columbia, masternya di Rutgers, dokternya memang sudah perjanjian, saya ke Rutgers itu ingin belajar model. Sengaja memang, jadi Arnold itu ingin, dia observasi, apa? Observasionalis juga sama seperti sensei, jadi orang yang survei bawa kapal dan sebagainya. Nah, tapi sebelum saya ke PhD, saya diarahkan ngambil master dulu belajar model. Dititip lah ceritanya. Nah, tapi on the way ke sana saya justru membangkang. Saya enggak bilang-bilang, saya kontak beliau, saya bilang saya tertarik dengan akustik. Bisa enggak saya sekolah di sana? Beliau kebetulan waktu itu mempunyai big funding 10 tahun. Apa dana gitu. Oh, bisa saja. Kalau Anda tertarik, saya butuh orang model. Kebetulan saya lulus. Jadi tidak lama-lama saya diundang beliau, dibiayai beliau dan sebagainya, langsung dijadikan faculty members. Tapi saya sambil sekolah. Untungnya di Amerika mereka apa terbuka gitu ya. Saya bilang setelah apa saya bilang saya pindah haluan dan sebagainya. Kenapa saya tertarik belajar akustik itu? Karena memang teknologi ini, teknologi bawah air yang memang cocok untuk perairan Indonesia yang banyak selat dan sebagainya. Saya pikir ini masa depan. Sehingga saya belajar itu katakanlah 20 tahun dulu, tahun-tahun 2000, jadi 2001 ya mulai, terus 2002 gitu. Saya ngambil PhD dengan beliau, sampai sekarang itu saya apa kirim juga mahasiswa Indonesia belajar, memang saya perkuat grup ini dan beliau mendukung sepenuhnya sampai sekarang. Jadi perkembangan katakanlah dari beliau ini 20 tahunan lebih nanti diceritakan. Sekarang ini teknologi ini, jadi teknologi akustik tomografi ini menggunakan gelombang suara bisa memetakan semua proses fisik yang ada di dalam air, di dalam bawah air. Mulai dari permukaan sampai kedalaman, itu kelebihannya. Jadi yang kita tahu untuk mengukur arus misalnya ADCP ya, acoustic Doppler current profiling. Itu kan ADCP-nya harus dibawa dan sebagainya. Ini enggak. Alatnya bisa dimonitor di pantai, yang penting transducernya dicemplungkan. 5 meter atau 10 meter tergantung. Nanti gelombang suara yang merambat persis seperti sonografi. Jadi kalau apa USG gitu ya, ibu-ibu hamil di USG, seperti seperti itu, remote sensing. Dari situ kita bisa. Jadi menurut saya ini luar biasa pengembangannya dan kami bersama-sama mengembangkan sampai beliau pensiun itu berapa tahun lalu, tapi beliau tetap sebagai emeritus karena digunakan sekali, masih aktif beliau, dan sayangnya menurut saya, tanda kutip, saya tidak mau ketinggalan, kita manfaatkan keahlian beliau. Beliau sekarang ini di Cina, ngasih kuliah dan supaya aktif, masih ini dua orang ini mahasiswa yang dia bimbing dan sebagainya, jadi saya ingin membawa dia ke Indonesia lewat BRIN dan UMPAD. Jadi kami membuat kolaborasi. Ini saya bilang di awal karena sebenarnya kunjungan ini tidak terencana. Tapi oke, karena kita Agustus mau survei, sebenarnya bersamaan dengan apa kemarin di Natalis dan sebagainya itu ada kendala. Jadi kita mundurkan Agustus. Jadi nanti datang lagi survei. Kami inginkan tomografi juga berkembang di sini setelah melihat itu, teman-teman kelautan terutama ya. Tapi sangat besar manfaatnya dengan perikanan. Kemarin saya ketemu Pak Rudi ya, Pak Rudi ada ya. Dia beliau S2 katanya pistok dan sebagainya, wah pas sekali. Saya menggunakan teknologi ini sudah melakukan percobaan untuk mengukur ikan yang ada di Teluk Mamuju. Pakai metode ini, itu bisa. Dan saya dengan sensei berapa kali kami coba menghitung ikan, jadi di satu kolam, di kolam di depan apa rektor waktu itu ada 12 ikan mas, kami hitung pakai ini. Jadi secara metodologi bisa dihitung, dan saya ingin nanti Pak Rudi dan sebagainya S3 ya mungkin di Cina lah ya, di Cina dan sebagainya dibimbing kami berdua untuk fistok. Nah fistok ini kebetulan saya di BRIN sedang mengkaji membuat skema apa kebijakan untuk fistok nasional. Jadi saya kira memang sampai sekarang kita tahu lah ya, fistok kan belum tuntas dan sebagainya. Terutama yang ingin kita introduce itu teknologinya. Dengan remote sensing kan nggak langsung apa menurut rantai makanan, tapi dengan ini ikannya langsung dihitung dan tidak perlu bawa kapal dan sebagainya. Alatnya nanti kita lihat. Jadi kurang lebih seperti itu, kita enjoy seperti Pak Dekan katakan, kita beruntung hari ini mendapatkan apa beliau ini menurut saya untuk bidang coastal akustik mereka beliau penemunya dan kita mendengar langsung dari penemunya. Banyak buku beliau, publikasi juga di jurnal kami bersama-sama itu di jurnal Q1 ya, kebanyakan jurnal Amerika seperti Geophysical Research Letters. Dan beliau belajar akustik itu, saya kira ini yang terakhir pengantar saya, mungkin perlu dicontoh dengan paling tidak di fakultas, paling enggak Indonesia. Jadi ketika Jepang, waktu itu ya, setelah kasus dan sebagainya di Hiroshima ada pemboman dan sebagainya, mereka bangkit belajar ke Amerika dan Profesor Arta Kaneko ini salah satu orang yang dikirim, memang dipilih orang-orang yang berbakat waktu itu dikirimkan, seperti mungkin tahu Yamagata, beliau temannya Yamagata dari Kyushu waktu itu saat, apa sebelahan ruangan masih dosen muda terpilih dikirimkan Profesor salah satunya salah atau mereka ini Profesor Yamagata dikirimkan ke Princeton untuk belajar climate gitu ya, modeling. Dan sekarang beliau jadi great profesor. Beliau ini dikirimkan ke MIT khusus untuk belajar akustik. Jadi mereka belajar langsung dari ahlinya di Amerika, di MIT, dan ilmu itulah dikembangkan. Bagusnya pemerintah mereka setelah pulang beliau dijadikan profesor di Hiroshima dan dikasihkan dana besar. Sehingga 10 tahun, sehingga saya di sana di-hire apa dengan yang gaji pegawai bukan beasiswa. Saya bersyukur apa dan respect kepada beliau, sampai sekarang pun beliau masih mendukung kami di BRIN waktu itu BPT untuk mengembangkan. Komunitasnya sudah berkembang. Nah, ini ingin saya apa tularkan ke teman-teman terutama yang kelautan, kita sama-sama mengembangkan ini. Makanya juga setelah ini kami ke Robo ya, Robo Company itu kan marine instrument juga yang bekerja sama dengan UMPAD. Ya, kita sama-sama lah. Terutama saya yakin saya sudah diminta oleh Angkatan Laut. Ini juga ada isu strategisnya itu juga karena yang Cina menggunakan beliau juga di situnya juga di Unhannya Cina gitu ya. Jadi ya kita juga nggak mau ketinggalan, kita harus berkembang juga untuk mengembangkan ini. Nah, saya sudah diminta Pak Kasal dan sebagainya, cuman saya masih fokus untuk UMPAD dulu lah, karena Pak Dekan minta saya bantu bikin Climate Center. Setelah Climate Center ini juga dimulai, baru kita masuk di instrumen untuk apa instrumen-instrumen tomografi. Nah, ini nanti besok Pak Dekan saya mungkin melihat selain Marine Station, mungkin apa yang bisa kita bantu pasang instrumen gitu ya. Konservasinya, ini konservasi kan program internasional. Saya kira itu yang saya melihat bisa kita andalkan dari UMPAD, dan kita berpikir dari situ apakah bisa kita buat, kita taruh alat ini, tomografi untuk memantau kondisi fisik, arusnya, salinitasnya, dan itu real time. Jadi ya kan sekarang lagi berkembang IoT ya, nah kita mungkin bisa lewat proposal dan sebagainya IoT itu kita kembangkan di konservasi ini. Dan itu akan menjadi model yang mungkin beberapa untuk nasional mungkin belum banyak, tapi di pihak lain kan IoT berkembang. Saya kira itu pengantarnya. Sorry Sensei, I took your time and now time is yours. An hour's okay, and then we will open for discussion, maybe 3 session or something like that with 3 questions. Dojo Sensei.
First, I should appreciate the
Fakar Tidin, Profesor Yudi,
San, and
Fadri-san. So, your introduction is very nice. Thank you very much. So,
next is... I'm very glad to be here and take a lecture here on... So I have never visited the Pajaralan University, but its environmental surrounding environment is very so nice. Pajaralan University is located very good place. It's nice. Do you know the tomography is a... Name, first of all, I explain the naming of tomography. Tomography is, means the image on the slice, section. So, you know very well computer-aided tomography. CT scan, when you want to check, inspect the cancer in the hospital. CT scan, computer-aided tomography is so famous. Using X-ray, image with fine spatial resolution is...
It is easy to use this.
Left figure shows the CT scan. Okay? Human body enters the machine, and machine is rotated to left lower figure shows the X-ray passing the human body from all omnidirection. Okay? And it's a very good image obtained. How cancer is, human is injured by cancer or go back to the one more. The right side shows a seismic tomography. Seismic is an earthquake. This Indonesia and Japan have a severe marine earthquake and tsunami attack the Indonesia and Japan. It's the same as same situation is we have. The seismic tomography uses the natural and artificial seismic wave. Seismic wave is a just sound wave. Name is different, name is used, but sound waves. So famous book is published, Aki, Richard, and many method of analysis is imported from seismic tomography. So, lower part ocean, coastal acoustic tomography, OAT, and CAT. So, two publication is exist, Ocean Acoustic Tomography, Cambridge University Press, and Coastal Acoustic Tomography. We published the Elsevier 2019. Number of station. Yet, in compared to the CT scan, number of station is so limited. Because it's not so easy to deploy the oceanic station, acoustic station in the ocean. So, number of station limited, but spatial resolution is better and better with increasing station number. Okay? So, cost average data obtained in the CAT along the lake is so accurate. This is the most advantage of CAT. Please memorize OAT CAT, okay? So, right figure shows a oceanic plate and mantle vertical section vertical slice image to yeah to right figure and you can you see the Japanese main island Kyushu Shikoku south of Kyushu Shikoku south of Honshu 5 red line is crossing the Pacific plate and Philippine plate. Upper oceanic plate and oceanic plate is Pacific plate sinking below the south of Japan. And this is imaged by the upper right figure. It's difficult to show the red zone shows a. Can you see the sloping red zone? Okay, it shows a sinking of Pacific plate below the Philippine plate. So this is a cause of Japanese earthquake. Okay? Maybe south of Indonesia also similar. I don't know clearly, but Atlantic plate sinking below the Indonesian archipelago, okay? And big tsunami occurred. Okay? So right lower right figure shows a hot spot in the Hawaii Island and Tahiti Island is mantle hot spot. Mantle is rising as a hot spot. Okay? So this is a result of seismic tomography. So next is a OAT experiment. It was done in the Mediterranean Ocean, Mediterranean Sea, 1978. So, acoustic station is deployed in the surrounding Mediterranean Sea. And do you know the Mediterranean Sea is a excess evaporation make a saline water? Saline water means heavy water is produced by excess evaporation. So this evaporation is make a vertical convection. It was target the European Mediterranean Sea OAT experiment. And right figure shows a coastal acoustic tomography. Okay? It's our publication is with the two former Chinese student cooperated and coastal acoustic tomography published in the Elsevier 2020. So the standard knowledge is presented here of CAT. Sound propagation in the ocean is source is T1 source transmitter sound and receiver of at T2 receiver is received by. So we can consider only Snell law of refraction. Okay? Snell law of refraction is considering the Snell law of refraction, we can simulate the propagating ray. Okay? And the v is a current velocity. C is a sound speed. Sound speed, C0, reference sound speed, and deviation sound speed, sound speed deviation from the reference. Okay? So delta C and V is measured by sound propagation and CAT experiment. So this is a standard most important time of flight equation, travel time equation. So TI is a travel time and gamma I plus minus is a two-way delay. Okay? So distance divide arc distance divided by C0 plus delta C plus minus V. Okay? And travel time is calculated of integration, calculated integration of delta S divided by speed. Okay? Delta C and V is we want to measure by the CAT measurement. Unknown variable, okay? Line integral. Line integral is solved. Travel time and unknown variable. Okay? Travel time is obtained in the ocean observation. CAT observation, and we want to know the delta C and V by the CAT observation. And red arrow shows the travel time simulation. Using the line integral, travel time should be estimated. This is a simulation. We cannot understand the real transmission path in the ocean. It's impossible to. So, but using the lowermost line, pink line shows the ray tracing method. Gamma I travel time is simulated by ray tracing method using the past CTD data. Okay. We called it a forward problem. And if we get the travel time data, if we solve this integral equation, delta C, V, unknown variable, delta C and V is obtained. Okay? This is the most important first equation of CAT study. So yeah, the horizontal, yeah, this is a sketch of the CAT experiment to imaging the Tokyo Bay. Okay, in this experiment, seven stations surrounding the Tokyo Bay, CAT 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and data obtained in each station, and so okay. Data obtained is transfer to the FTP server using the mobile phone antenna. Okay, so. Yeah, CAT platform is top two figures show the Hiroshima Bay experiment. Lower two figures show the Bali Strait experiment. Okay? And next is CAT controller and transducer is very compact. In the underwater acoustics, big advantage is everything is compact, not heavy. Very small transducer and small, yeah, it's a big advantage. We bring the small instrument to the ocean and everything is obtained. GPS signal, clock signal coming from the satellite. GPS clock signal, is used and GPS positioning data is also obtained in the HAT instrument. So this is a Professor Zhu Xiaohua, SIO. Now the Ministry of Natural Resources could provide this animation. The south of Zhoushan Island, Zhoushan Island, Zhejiang University of Marine College is located. Two students coming this meeting. So using seven station data, Professor Zhu Xiaohua provides the animation. So eastward current is upper right corner, it's sea level data is moving, red dot moving on the along the black line. Okay, and if tide is come to the neap tide and direction change to the eastward and not so interesting profile obtained, but now the AGCP shipboard data is overwrite. And such a mapping is obtained. Okay? So here I want to talk about the Bali Strait. We built Bali Strait 2014-2016. 3 years, we focus the Bali Strait with a Hadley and but data is obtained, but something is remain to be studied. This is the most important point. The remaining thing is exist for the Bali Strait. Bali Strait is a tidal wave coming from the Indian Ocean. Yeah? And pink arrow shows the tidal wave coming from the Indian Ocean and enter the Bali Strait, and Bali Strait northward widths of strait is continuously shrink. If northern exit of Bali Strait 2 kilometer narrow gap exists. Narrow, very narrow, but gap exists. Okay? If this gap is closed, what happening? Closed is a tidal wave cannot enter the Bali Strait. If 2 kilometer gap is closed, tidal wave cannot enter the Bali Strait. That's very important. If small gap exists, very dangerous situation is occur in the northern part of Bali Strait. Important ferry boat route operated, Banyangi and Gilmark. So this is a Dr. Hadley-san have interest in this to ask us to the CAT observation. And Bali Strait, important strait with a ferry route connecting Java and Bali. Important ferry route. But dangerous strait with a 3-hour oscillation. Surprisingly strong 3-hour oscillation. Northward maximum current 2.5 meters per second and 1.5 hour later. southward 2.5 hour southward current. No, no captain cannot control whale, of course. Even in the Japanese dangerous strait, 6 hour north M2 tide, 6 hour from the eastward current change to the east westward current. But very straight, 1.5 hour northward current change to the southward current. Surprising. Why it occurred? 2 kilometer gap is exist, so dangerous situation appear. So after our experiment 2016 finish, ferry boat sank accident. Okay. Also the around the 2020 Navy submarine missing. Some Indonesian student Aruni teach me, but so we did the 2006, we show the 2016 data S1, S3, S5, S7 for station located, okay? But white circle shows the west white circle shows the weak, its current is suddenly strong and cannot fix the station and flow drifted. So we have no data. And also the West Valley Northern Park in front of the West Valley National Park, if we want to set the one station, much better data obtained. But anyway, this time we have a four station data. If the station number is greater than four, inversion and mapping can be done. Okay, so the data is show this. So SSH, sea surface height change is the upper figure. Okay? The high water, low water, yeah, flat tide, high water, neap tide, low water, and low water. This is a M2 tide, okay? half day tide. So this half day M2 tide exists means a 2 kilometer gap is open, exist. If closed, no M2 tidal current. Okay? Low water, strong 3 hour oscillation is generated. Its data shows this clearly. And low water, 3 hour oscillation generated. High water, nothing. That's the most important data obtained. And so it's some northward current 1.5 hour later. Yeah, current is changed to southward. Okay, like this. But something is a problem. Some result is spreading, but so this straight width is only 5 kilometers, but this most dangerous area ferry route is operated. Gilmark to Paniangi ferry route, when we get on the ferry boat, captain annoy the operation. It's only 5 kilometers. Sometimes 30 minutes, 1 hour is needed to arrive. counter station. Okay.
Three hours. In, even for the Japanese captain, it's Japanese captain don't do such a work, maybe. So if this is a 5 kilometer point, but if 10 kilometer point, nothing occur, no problem. Dangerous situation is disappear. 5 minutes. So I focus this. I want to ask the Indonesian oceanographer to, okay? If northern exit is closed, black line and blue line, sea surface, and only 1.5 hour sage, standing wave is generated. Okay? But if a small gap, pink line, watching the right corner, and pink sea surface, and if open to the Java Strait, the sea surface is no change. Okay? So it's an important point. Okay? And strong current occur. So, and northern exit close is a M2 tide, cannot intrude into the strait. Yeah, but nothing, no interesting phenomena occur. But northern exit is opened with a tiny gap. Something occur. Okay? Dangerous situation occur is a, but hypothesis is a strong 3 hour oscillation is generated as a result of biharmonic resonance. 1.5 hour stage and 3 hour oscillation is a two times difference in period. So MCAT is something is a, this is a MCAT experiment is planned in the Makassar Strait Labani Channel. September is planned to measure the Indonesian through flow. So MCAT means a mirror type CAT means a, okay? Data is obtained land station using the mirror transmission. Okay? I have no time to explain this, but its experiment will be soon started. So Bali, Northern Lombok Strait experiment, we did the this 2019, we did some data and quick publication was done. Dr. Fadri San and geophysical research data and depth is 400 meter was deployed depth. And it's interesting, big difference, travel time, big difference obtained. This is a big change of temperature, okay? Correspond to the big change of temperature. And this southern part of, southern inlet of Lombok Strait, shear bank exists. M2 tide over the shear bank, okay? To internal solitary wave, big 100 meter amplitude. This is a Dewi Santo, Indonesian, great scientist working in the Maryland University. And his sonograph is a catch the this internal solitary wave, 150 meter wave height is so big. So the Makassar Strait experiment is planned September 2000,
west of Mamuju City, west Sulawesi, M1, M2, M3, M4 is deployed, and M0, M00 is a land station. Data is obtained after deployment of CAT. Data obtained come to the land station. Every data comes to the land station using the travel time summation, VLA transmission. So, yeah, Sendana, two days later, we beat this Sendana M0 station, M00 station is some coastal block or breakwater exist. Maybe the ship is landing. Okay? But the first three-step experiment is planned. First step, 5 days. Next is a one-month experiment. Third step, one-year experiment. Step by step, it should be developed. Chinese instrument and Hadrian support and I coordinator and it will be done. So, 9,000 meters is a transducer depth. If we put the transducer at this depth, very good distribution of acoustic ray is obtained. Okay? So, I estimate the maximum distance is 60 kilometers. And using the 5 kilohertz, so it's possible or not. Using the sonar equation, I estimate that it's possible. So finally, international conference is end of August 28, 2022 is international conference held here for Fajardan University and Hadrian and Chupan National University Defense Technology. Professor Chupan is coordinate combiner and first experiment is but dot schedule is tentative, not fixed. Thank you so much. Terimakashi.
いや、ありがとう先生。So I open for the position, which you can just write your hand. いや、silakan Pak. Bebas bahasanya Pak, bahasa Sunda gitu dan naon.
Iya, terima kasih. Arigato gozaimasu sensei. Very interesting for your information to me. Watashi wa Iskandar Sang desu.
Nihongo.
Pak, mungkin saya nanya bahasa Indonesia aja supaya nanti. Ini Pak, kalau kita lihat memang Indonesia kan sekarang lagi terutama untuk kepulauan ya Pak ya. Kan kita lagi ngembangkan juga tentang apa mariculture Pak. Mariculture budidaya ikan di laut dan mungkin apakah dengan alat ini bisa apa informasi terutama misalnya arus ya kemudian batimetrinya dasar perairannya begitu bisa tergambarkan tidak Pak supaya kita mungkin nanti kalau untuk mariculture penempatan apa karamba jaring apungnya itu ya tepat lah seperti jangan sampai kemarin waktu ada di Pangandaran yang offshore itu kebawa arus gitu Pak nah itu kan supaya itu tidak terjadi apakah dengan apa teknologi ini bisa di apa diaplikasikan. Saya dari ini Pak, dari Departemen Perikanan kebetulan dari minat aquaculture. Terima kasih Pak Pendik.
Makasih Pak. Saya kira tiga penanya dulu Pak ya biar nanti saya gabung. Ada yang penanya kedua? Is there any others? From oh okay. Please.
Okay. So if I'm not mistaken, you said something about the Bali Strait is shrinking, and you said that it's dangerous because tidal waves cannot enter that strait if that happened. So I want to ask if there's is there any mitigation that we should do? Is there any danger besides it can sink boats and submarines if the condition happen? And what else dangers that lies if the condition of Bali Straits keep getting worse, like it keeps shrinking and etc. Is that clear?
Yeah, okay.
Thank you.
The last question for the first session. Penanya ketiga ada? Student? No? Okay, Sensei. The first session, they have two questions. The first one is the lecturers, senior lecturers, asking you about how can our cats help for the marine cultures? You can say about your experience in the Hiroshima Bay, oyster, whatever it is. So how important we need this early warning system?
That's a cats? Very good question. So in marine aquaculture, is temperature is very important factor. Okay? Temperature 1 degree, 2 degree temperature increase or temperature decrease. It can be measured by cat and some network. Something, if you understand that some cold water coming from here and it's a protected area, is aquaculture area here, and catch and something. Of course, the surrounding the marine aquaculture is a cat station should be located. And if this from something cold water come from this direction, is something is a catch the to using the two cat station can be measured the temperature. This system is operated. You can find the what something occur in the marine aquaculture.
Very helpful. And tomorrow we will visit the fishing nets of lobster in a conservation area. And we will try to see the condition. And I think it is good if we can establish, if we need it, this tomography early warning system, what kind of the name, using IoT technology. Yeah. Yes. The second question, Sensei, it's mostly how to mitigate the dangers of striking in the Bali Strait. And the second one, maybe you can explain the other dangers like submarine navy. It should be related with the very narrow gap inlets. So two questions, you see. First one is how to mitigate the dangers of this dangerous Bali Strait.
Yeah, good question. So first thing is to change the ferry route. That is just southward, 10 kilometers or something. If mitigation is ferry boat route is shifted to the southward at 10 kilometers or something, it's much safety. But mitigation is active current is 3 hour oscillation is disturbed this area. This is a very good water mixing. If not so dangerous, it's not so bad. Vertical mixing of the water is. So
maybe the best one is to establish the monitoring system, Sensei, in the Bali Strait to mitigate for these dangers.
Yeah. If possible, the Indonesian scientists.
Yeah, Ministry of Transportation.
Try to do one more experiment. Okay? But at the, I think the in front of the natural park, one station is located, situation much better. But I think that if ferry boat captain don't know the something occur. But if ferry boat captain shift the ferry boat route southward little bit, the more safety. Okay, so second question
is maybe you can explain how dangerous this with the submarine. Another danger is the submarine.
Navy submarine missing is I heard this information is the occurrence place is around the northern narrow gap region around.
Ini kapal yang Nenggala itu ya, kapal selam itu jatuh.
So
tempo hari.
US Dwi Santo, US professor, Indonesian professor says it's related to the
internal wave,
but it's far from the Lombok Strait, close to the CAT experimental site. Okay. So, but if Navy captain, Navy submarine captain knows this dangerous of the around the northern exit of it's maybe safety.
Ay, arigato, sensei.
Yes.
Mungkin sedikit saya perjelas ya. Jadi di Selat Bali saya banyak dengan sensei melakukan penelitian. Memang di sana berbahaya. Pertama arusnya kencang sekali karena ada gapnya kecil banget ya. Jadi kayak cok. Arusnya kencang di sana bisa sampai 3. Pengukuran kami dengan alat ini bisa sampai 3,5 meter. Itu cepat sekali. 3,5 meter per detik itu sama dengan 7 knot gitu. Kencang. Dan itu berbahaya. Berbahayanya karena bisa kita bagi jadi 3 lapis. Padahal kedalamnya kan hanya 100-an meter. 3 lapis itu di permukaan arusnya misalnya ke selatan, di bawahnya lagi ke utara, di bawahnya lagi ke selatan. Makanya banyak penyelam bahkan angkatan laut gitu nyelam langsung hanyut. Hilang mereka. Jadi emang bahaya yang sensei katakan itu sebenarnya karena ada inlet yang sempit di utara itu arus kenceng dan sebagainya ada pertukaran. Ya, mixing dan pertukaran massa air itu kan juga kalau kita belajar oceanografi menyebabkan strong vertical mixing yang tadi pertukarannya ke atas itu yang menjadi bahaya. Dan tadi arusnya juga ekstrim, berlapis-lapis, karena yaitu tadi di selatannya kan ada masukan dari arus pasut. Sehingga dia berosilasi secara natural itu, dia bilang seichi, gelombang berdiri ya, terus saja 1,5 per jam. Tapi hasil dari modulasi dengan pasang surut dan sebagainya itu, di sana punya osilasi 3 jaman, itu yang bikin bahaya. Dan dia bahaya lainnya, pertanyaan tadi, bahaya lainnya beliau menduga Pak Dwi Susanto, ya, profesor di University of Maryland, menduga itu karena internal wave. Beliau katakan, saya juga sependapat, internal wave terlalu jauh dan itu di Laut Jawa, di utaranya lebih dekat ke sini. Jadi mungkin efek yang beliau katakan, efek dari osilasi yang terjadi di Selat Bali ini daripada yang dimana osilasinya juga kan seperti internal wave, 3 jaman tadi. Kalau memang tinggal gelombang berdirinya berarti osilasi 1,5 jam ini. Ini yang menghentas kapal selam kita jatuh ke bawah gitu kurang. Saya kira masih, just finish. Maybe last question, if, one more last question if from student, yes, okay. Last CC, from student.
Oh, nice. Okay, good afternoon, Professor Kaneko. Thank you for your opportunity. Lately, we've been shocked by the sunk of the submarine by OceanGate, and it was 4,000 matter under the surveys. And something that I want to ask you is there this coastal acoustic tomography can do to solve that problem? Thank you.
Sorry, say again.
Okay. Is there something that this coastal acoustic tomography can do to solve the problem about the sink? Is there something explode or to detect something dangerous under the surface? And how this tomography can work?
What kind of dangers? Like oil spill or whatever?
Spears?
Oil spill. So you said the dangers. What is the danger in the surface?
Because the depth, kedalamannya kan mencapai 4.000 meter. Nah, sebenarnya apakah benar-benar bahan atau teknologi ini atau inovasi ini sebenarnya mampu untuk mengatasi hal tersebut hingga kedalaman 4.000 meter? Bukankah itu sesuatu yang sangat sebenarnya menantang sekali?
Gitu? Masalahnya di kedalaman ya?
Iya.
Okay. So Sensei, she is curious about the depth. How can our cat go deeper? to measure any kind of phenomena in the water columns. So how deep that we can go for our coastal acoustic tomography to measure any ocean phenomena?
Just to example, he said like 4,000. How can we go for 4,000 or 7,000?
Yes. Good example is coming Makassar Strait experiment. It's very deep. So, yeah. Maximum depth is 2,300 meters. Looks like deep ocean. So, Columbia University Professor Arnold Gordon is a long-term AGCP mooring here. Also, Chinese SIO professor did this same thing. So, this is so deep. But one AGCP mooring is, I think, not enough. So, if we deploy the whole CAT, MCAT, CAT station, CAT is possible, but if we can deploy the MCAT, MIRACAT. We can get the all data in the land station. Okay? During the observation, we don't stay ocean. Okay? After deployment, we can go back to land. Every person, every scientist go back to land. And data coming to the land station. This is a very deep, so we have to put the transducer, the MCAT station at 900 meters. Axis of underwater sound channel. Okay.
Thank you, Jesse.
Thank you.
So, apa untuk bahasa Indonesia ya? Jadi metode ini tidak terbatas oleh kedalaman. Jadi, tapi tergantung oleh frekuensi. Jadi ada transducer. Transducer itu mentransmit juga mereceive sinyal. Jadi tergantung transducer kita itu masing-masing kan punya frekuensi. Kalau pakai ADCP misalnya, laut dalam ya frekuensinya lebih rendah. Yang dangkal-dangkal pakai frekuensi tinggi. Jadi tergantung frekuensi dari transducer. Tidak tergantung kedalaman. Jadi bisa semua fenomena apapun hanya transducer makin frekuensinya rendah itu makin mahal. Jadi misalnya kita mau 5 kilo di daerah konservasi tadi KJA, itu lebih murah. Jadi cukup pakai frekuensi katakanlah maybe for 5 kilometer we can use 10 kilohertz. That's enough. Yeah. Jadi tergantung sama frekuensinya ya. Semua fenomena intinya dengan tomografi ini tidak tergantung kedalaman dan semua fenomena yang ada di dalam kolom air sama tadi seperti ilustrasi dengan USG gitu ya, itu kita bisa memetakan, mengetahui fenomena yang fisik terutama arusnya, gelombangnya dan sebagainya yang terjadi dalam kolom air. Saya kira gitu ya, Mbak ya. Give big applause to Kaneko Sensei. Dan terima kasih atas perhatian semuanya. Saya berikan kembali ke panitia. Silakan.
Once again, a round of applause for both speaker and moderator. Thank you, Professor Arata Kaneko, who led the presentation and gave us lots of information and new insight. Also, thanks to Professor Fadli, who led the discussion so it went smoothly. Moving on to our next agenda, we will give our token of appreciation to our speaker, Professor Arata Kaneko. The first one will be given by Vice Dean, Dr. Mega Laksmini. Oh, it's okay if we do it on the stage, maybe. So the first one is for Professor Kaneko. It's over there, sorry. All right. For the documentation, please. One. Professor, you can see to look at the camera. Okay, so 3, 2, 1. Once again, 3, 2, 1. Okay, applause for Dr. Mega and Professor Kaneko. And another token of appreciation from the International Office will be handed by Ms. Fitri Melianawati. Ms. Fitri, you may come to the stage. For the documentation session,
another what?
Another token of appreciation from us. Right, please look at the camera. Okay, in 3, 2, 1. Once again, 3, 2, 1. Okay, thank you. Now, for Professor Fadli, we also have token of appreciation. Another one will be handed by Dr. Mega Laksmini. You may come to the stage again. Okay, for the documentation, 3, 2, 1. Once again, 3, 2, 1. Thank you for the speakers, moderator, and Dr. Mega for this session. Now we finally reached the end of the event. Thank you so much for the participants who have attended this event until the end with such enthusiasm. Hopefully, the knowledge gained will be helpful in the present and the future. I am Shakira as the master of ceremony. From the deepest of my heart, I apologize for any kind of mistakes I did, both verbally and in form of actions during this event. Thank you so much and have a good day. Maybe before we close this event, there's a documentation session with